Hey guys, so last time we did a video called Bug Fixes and Improvements that we need in Tower Heroes. And to my surprise, some of the features actually got added. Like for example the difficulty stars and skin previewing. Well, this video is actually pretty similar. There is only one major difference. This time it is features and things I would like to see for quote-unquote content creators and live streamers, because I feel like these features would for one make me able to make better videos for you guys, and for two make it able to do things that I really want to do in the game but just can't because of limitations. So without further ado, let's jump straight into it. Yeah! You probably already expected this, but the mute music button and the mute specter button don't save, and they really should. It is super annoying. It ruins live streams and videos. To be honest, this is the one suggestion that isn't even a question for me. I am actually begging you, please make the mute buttons safe. It is actually needed for live streaming. Yeah. The second thing that I want is on the hero menu. Like I said, I am super grateful and I think it's super cool that you can now view level upgrades on the hero screen. But there is one little feature missing that I personally would really appreciate, as it would help me in making Road to Remskin videos, for example. And that is an option to yellow, red, green or even blue screen the background. Right now the background is gray and a lot of skins have gray elements in them. So chroma keying them can be quite annoying. But nothing is more annoying than that the gray box behind it is actually a little bit transparent. So if something or someone walks through your frame, well, I guess you can't ultra key it anymore. This is not the most important feature that I would want, but still one that I would really appreciate. Yeah! If you have been on the channel for at least a couple of days, you probably recognize this map in an instant. And that is because I always use this map when previewing skins. And that is not because I like how the map looks or anything. I mean, I like how it looks, but there is a far more important thing why I'm always choosing this map. And that is the lighting, because this map has one of the most cleanest lighting in the games, so you can see the skins the best. Compare that to my favorite map in the game, Glowing Glacier. And what you notice is that the skin doesn't look that nice anymore. What I would want is that content creators get a button and when they click it, the lighting in the game changes to the exact same lighting of Castle Town. Because that would be absolutely amazing to have more maps available to showcase skins at. Yeah. One of the things I love about Tower Heroes is the spectate mode. You can fly around, zoom in and out, and even hold the shift key to go slower. But that is where the problem lies. Because even when pressing the shift key, it still doesn't go slow enough. What I really would want is a spectate mode that would go even slower than this. The reason for that would be that when we get a slow mode that gets even slower than that, we can make even cooler cinematic shots, which I absolutely would love to use in videos. Yeah! And a feature that I would love is for an option to hide other people's level and name tag. When I want to record with a buddy, for example Tony, it makes it much more clean and professional when you can't see the other person's name tag. Yeah. Oh boy, I guess it's time for the big one, the invite manager. If you have been to my live streams, you know what an absolute chaos it is. People wanna get invited, but some people never are able to join the lobby. Sometimes something really cool joins, like a developer, or a contributor, or even an old friend, and they can't join the match. This is something that I would really, really want for streamers, and it is to add this button right here. An invite button. And clicking the invite button would open up what I like to call the invite manager, in which you can pick the map, invite all your friends, and play the game. Of course, the maximum would still be 8 because we don't want to cheat, but this would absolutely be amazing and help me so, so much. I would even go as far as to offer to code it myself, if that is something that you guys are interested in, as this is something that I absolutely would love in the game. Yeah. While I feel like this would be one of the most unlikely things to be added in the game, I just couldn't make a video about this topic without adding it in, and that would be a sandbox mode. You won't get any coins, you won't get any XP, but you can decide which enemies spawn, when enemies spawn. Towers don't have a limit, towers don't cost mana, you can upgrade them all the way, you can equip all the skins in the game. This would make life so much easier. Once again, I feel like this is the most unlikely thing ever to be added, but I just had to include it, even for that little chance. Let's move on to the final thing. Yeah. And the final thing would be access to assets. So with assets, I mean models like the coin model, models of the towers, maybe even the maps, just stuff like that. And the reason for that is that they could be really useful for setting up special live streams, like skin making. Making thumbnails could be way easier, like maybe you can use the coins to make a cool backdrop. It would just help out a lot. Now, first things first, I understand why they don't have a place with all the assets, because asset theft is something that exists and is a very scary, so I totally agree. But it would be really cool to have a place where they invite people that they trust with all the assets. While I have been asking for stuff in the past, for example the Voca model, to make a skin together on a live stream, there is something that is called anxiety and fear. The fear to be annoying. Because let's be honest, when you keep asking somebody for stuff again and again and again, it can get quite annoying. And the last thing that I would want to do is be annoying to the developers. So yeah, those were basically all the ideas I could think of. Are there any that I missed? Let me know. Once again, I am not expecting any of these features to be added. But it's just really fun to think about all the stuff that could have been to help video editors out a little bit. But anyway guys, thank you all so much for watching. If you like this video and want to see more, please hit that like and subscribe button. And I will see you guys in the next video. Bye bye!